Good Monday, everyone. This is meteorologist Dave Snyder at the National Weather Service with Alaska statewide weather. Pretty quiet across most of Alaska today. There are several areas of dense fog up across the north slope and very close to the coastline itself as we head into tonight. That will likely increase as we head through the evening and overnight hours. Look out across the Bering Sea shows two areas of low pressure. One of those 995 millibar lows is sitting just to the west of the Pribilof Islands with an occlusion working down across the central and eastern Aleutians and up toward the Alaska Peninsula. Ahead of that, a little bit of fog on the northern side of the peninsula heading toward Bristol Bay. A much larger low-pressure system sitting out across the Gulf of Alaska at 989 millibars. A lot of dry air wrapped around that, not causing too much trouble there today. But a little bit further to the east and south of British Columbia and the Pacific Northwest, we see a little bit broader fetch of moisture working up from the south and east, and that will increase the area of rainfall across southeastern Alaska tonight. Across the Copper River Basin, points north across the eastern Alaska Range and across the Alcan border, we expect some areas of light snow tonight. Shouldn't be anything spectacular, but you may see some of the frozen precipitation in your region. Across South Central, pockets of rainfall should be possible around Prince William Sound and mainly along the Chugach Mountains and perhaps down toward Homer. Most of that should be fairly light. Out across the Bering Sea, expect areas of rain and snow to mix around the Pribilofs, and isolated rain and snow showers possible there. With low pressure tracking eastward through the central and eastern Aleutians, a 992 millibar low will likely produce a better chance for some light rain and showers heading through the central and eastern chain all the way through the Alaska Peninsula. On the northern side of that, rain and snow showers are expected to continue around St. Matthew and points west and north all the way out towards Shemya. And a little bit further east, across the eastern Gulf, rain and thunderstorms are possible, mainly along coastal areas and offshore, ahead of another wave of low pressure at 997 millibars, a little bit closer to the open water of the Gulf. For South Central and along the Alcan border, expect periods of rain showers there as we head into Tuesday night and into Wednesday. The unsettled and drippy weather will be possible across South Central and the Copper River Basin heading into Wednesday, with a considerable amount of dry air across the north slope, south of the Brooks Range, the Koyukuk Valley, and out toward the Seward Peninsula. Watch for some areas of showers there around the middle Yukon Valley. Most of the interior will stay dry as a result of that drier air working in across the north and western parts of the state. Meanwhile, southeast will continue to see some light rainfall as we head into Wednesday afternoon. With Alaska statewide weather, this is meteorologist Dave Snyder.